Hello and welcome. My name is Felix Denzinger and in this video I want to briefly present to you our work on coronary plaque analysis for CT angiography clinical research. So the medical background behind this topic is that due to inflammation of the tissue surrounding vasculature and due to perturbations in the blood flow, plaque deposits can aggregate within the vessel wall. These plaque deposits can then rupture, which may lead to stroke or myocardial infarction, or they can block the blood flow and therefore lead to ischemia. And what's actually relevant in clinical research is to analyze the composition of those plaque deposits, because some of those high-risk plaques, which are prone to rupture, can be very well distinguished by looking at the different tissue types in these plaque deposits. So what we are actually presenting here is a software solution to enable research in the field of coronary artery plaque analysis. And for this, we have set the following requirements. It should allow reproducible research. So most of the processes within the software solution should be as automated as possible to allow for reproducible results and also speed up the workflow. Furthermore, we need some flexibility that if the automated algorithms do not yield feasible results, then we should be able to easily correct them. And also, a big requirement in clinical research is to enable current and future research trends. Namely, in the case of this prototype, we enable research in the direction of analysis of the perivascular tissue and also in research using dual energy scans. So the workflow under the hood looks as follows. You start with a computed tomography scan of the coronary vasculature. Then in the first step, the heart is segmented in order to enable the further processing. And then the center lines of the vessels are extracted such that you can select those parts of the vessel which you want to analyze further. And then within these regions of interest, you can actually segment the vessel wall in order to then analyze it with respect to what kind of tissue is inside of those plaque deposits. And the algorithms used under the hood here are, for once, for the heart isolation mask, a approach from Seng and others. Is utilized, which used marginal space learning and steerable features. Then for the centerline extraction, also an approach from Seng and others is used, which uses prior knowledge about the course of the centerlines in combination with a data-driven model. And this is, as of today, still the top performing fully automated approach on the Rotterdam Centerline Extraction Challenge. For the wall segmentation, you need an algorithm for the inner and the outer vessel wall. For the inner vessel wall, an approach proposed by Lugauer and others, utilizing ray casting and subsequent analysis of a Markov random field graph is used, which is again the top performing fully automated approach on the Rotterdam coronary lumen segmentation challenge. And finally, for the outer wall segmentation, a bit older approach proposed by Großkopf and others is used, which utilizes a combination of 2D and 3D snakes, and this approach is adaptable using thresholds. So this is by far the oldest approach, being proposed in 2009, but segmentation of the outer wall is highly reader dependent, so in order to cope for that, an approach which is actually easily adaptable using thresholds is not a bad choice here. So, as I said, the outer wall is highly reader dependent, so we need to allow easy correction if the segmentation result is not sufficient. And this is solved by modeling the vessel walls as implicit surfaces, so that when you adapt those contour points, you actually change the surface function in order to make an anatomical coherent change in those vessel walls. This we also, of course, have manual correction tools for the center lines and the inner wall as well. In the prototype, the manual correction tool looks as follows. You would just go into the editing mode and simply draw the new contours. As you can see, the contouring algorithm does have some problems at bifurcations, and still you want to smooth out some of the outer vessel wall in some regions. And with this, you can simply exit the edit mode again and then have an updated surface of the vessel segmentation. Another topic that is enabled by this research is the analysis of perivascular fat. It was shown that there is a correlation between the mean HU attenuation of that fat and inflammation. And luckily, those regions of interest which were defined in the original publication are well defined with fixed dimensions, so we are able to automate this process. And as you can see in this video, the automated mode directly sets the starting and end point of the regions of interest. So for the right coronary artery, it's 10 millimeters from the ostium, and then for the next 40 millimeters, and for the left coronary artery and the circumflex, the region of interest starts after the bifurcation between those. And here you can actually also see the full user interface of this prototype. So you have an UI element where you can actually have a look at the composition of the plaque you're currently looking at, and also with an histogram, and everything can of course be exported. You have some 2D measurements tools on the cross sections, and on the left hand side you see the measurements for the perivascular case in this instance, where you have the mean HU value, the standard deviation, and the median value. Also on the left side you can see different center line editing and plaque editing functionalities. So this footage here is actually sped up by a factor of 2. So this automated mode runs in a time frame of 2 minutes, and the pre-processing for like the heart isolation mass calculation takes approximately 3 to 5 seconds, and the center line extraction approximately 60 seconds. So with inner communication within the software, the pre-processing should be finished within 90 seconds or something, which is definitely feasible for clinical research. Another topic of current and future research is the use of dual energy scans to better understand the tissue composition of those plaque deposits. And this is done by, the motivation behind this is that fibrotic and lipid-rich tissue can overlap in the HU values of computed tomography, but it's differentiable using dual energy. So you can have a threshold between the calcified and fibrous fatty tissue, and then analyze the lipid-rich and the fibrotic tissue further using the dual energy index. So, since this is a software publication, it's actually also used in some clinical publications so far. As we are aware of, 17 clinical publications using this prototype exist so far. Examples for them are Tesche and others, which extract quantitative plaque features and then correlate them with an invasive FFR, which is the gold standard to determine whether a plaque deposit should be, or whether a vessel should be revascularized or not. Then Rastiu and others examine the correlation between the geometry of a plaque and its vulnerability, which means how prone a plaque is to rupture. And as a third example, Morayu and others extract quantitative plaque features for patients which suffered a myocardial infarction and then see which kind of plaque feature correlate with future cardiac events. Actually, there exist more solutions for this topic. Most solutions include a semi or automated pre-processing and also correction tools. But to the best of our knowledge, none supports dual energy scans and only a few support perivascular tissue analysis. So, summarizing, we present a prototype software which enables clinical research for coronary CT angiography. It utilizes state-of-the-art algorithm while allowing for as much automation as possible to ensure reproducibility and speed up clinical research. And also, it allows research in upcoming directions, which are the analysis of perivascular tissue and dual energy scans. In upcoming work, we may integrate segment labeling and also support photon counting scans to allow research in that direction. And with this overview slide, I want to conclude my presentation and would be happy to discuss this work with you in the poster session.